My father, my grandfather, my grand-grandfathers were living somewhere. They were building their own environment. And then we are taking all of this from them, and then we are passing to our sons.
You were like the main architect of Barcelona for 4 years. What problems you solved during that time?
Yeah, the question was how we can apply the internet model to the physical world. How internet will change the cities, or how we can take the potential of this to improve the life of people. For example, we were working with digital fabrication, and we say we should bring digital fabrication and innovation all over the city. We should bring, for example, free Wi-Fi to the public space as a civic right to have access to internet in the same way that we have shadow from a tree or we have light from the lamps. We were working with the new bus network in order to make the city more symmetrical and equal everywhere. We learned also how to make cheap and fast projects, that this is something we already forgot. A city needs to have very expensive and long-term projects that are the structural elements like high-speed train station and others, but we need to do very fast and very cheap projects in every corner in order to improve the quality of life of people. So my mission was to play all these roles at the same time.
And what about the difference between the rich people and the poor people in Barcelona?
We have been trying to kill the different center and periphery with many projects. So we invest more money per inhabitant in the poorest neighborhoods than not in the richest neighborhood, first. Second, we try to apply the same kind of solutions, the same lighting, furniture, materials in the center and the areas that are not so central. You know that the poorest neighborhoods are those that doesn't have working areas, are mostly residential areas. So our mission was to bring working areas to these places and even to bring tourists and to bring, we're opening places that has an incredible value, but they were abandoned because they were not in the center. So what we were doing was to say, this place is, this has the same rights as that one.
What Russia should do with its industrial past? For example, a building like this. Should such buildings be renovated?
During the economical development of cities, developers are trying somehow to use the city as an investment place and trying to take the fastest profit as possible. And then this is what happened in Barcelona in the year 2000s. And then with the bubble of construction, and many industrial areas wanted to be transformed into residential areas. So we start to lose just because we say, oh, the Chinese can fabricate. But then we start thinking that by making construction or speculation, we could live. Then the crisis showed that this is not true. First of all, the jobs were moved to China. We don't have jobs anymore. And the industrial areas were lost because we were doing housing for no one. What I see now in Moscow is that 30% of the center inside the third ring is to be industrial and is being transformed, trying to be transformed into residential or mixed use areas. In 20 years, you will be thinking how to bring jobs back to the center. Yeah. That this is what is happening in New York, in London, and in Barcelona. So Moscow should learn from what other cities did before and the phenomena that happened.
So you heard about the project, renovation project that's been on in Moscow.
I know that in Russia you have a fast construction 50s and 60s. The quality of buildings are not good. And the question is what to do with this. There are two basic strategies. Make buildings nearby. You demolish the buildings and you move the people, or you try to renovate. So both strategies are okay. What is fundamental is to share, to discuss, to talk, to explain, etc. This is the way people can accept projects, because it's not that the king or whoever say this is good and this is bad. today we live in democratic countries, and then we need to discuss things and accept the people, because when you destroy a neighborhood, you destroy the physical part, but you destroy also the social part. And thinking that a good transformation will take 25 years, so you need to have a good plan and start to invest a little bit every year, and then in 25 years, things will change.
And to be in power for 25 years.
But it's not, I mean, the best projects are those that have a long-term agreements. So politics should be beyond some kind of basic decisions about how cities work. The best cities are those that whatever they decide, they can develop the project in an aligned way between government, citizens, and companies and experts. But if every 4 years there is another decision, a different decision, then this is a disaster.
Если видео показалось вам интересным, нажмите мне понравилось и подписывайтесь на канал. Заходите на сайт в раздел «Я хочу поддержать проект, чтобы сделать пожертвование». If you find this video interesting, click like and subscribe. Visit our website, click support the project to make a donation.